and thank you for joining me today to learn about RBC Express's ACH Record Manager. This video is the first in a two-video series. In this video, we'll be looking at how to set up payment groups and payment records in preparation for Part 2, where we will send payment files. Before we look at the platform, here are some important terms and concepts. ACH stands for Automated Clearinghouse. The ACH Record Manager is an online payment service that can be used in two different ways. The first way is to make direct deposits for outgoing payments, for things like payroll or paying vendors and suppliers. The second way is for collecting incoming payments, called preauthorized payments, for purposes like rent, fees, and dues. Your RBC Express profile may allow for one or both of these payment types. Keep in mind throughout this video series that the steps to use the ACH Record Manager are the same whether you're collecting preauthorized payments or disbursing the outgoing direct deposits. The only difference will be the client number that you select when setting up the payments. The client number is a 10-digit ACH account number. You may have one or more client numbers on your platform. Beside the client number will be an acronym that indicates PAP, PDB, or PDS. PDB and PDS are both indicators of outgoing or direct deposits. The difference in these two acronyms has to do with billing. Your client number also contains a currency indicator for either CAD or USD. The ACH Record Manager being covered in this video is used to set up ACH payment files. A payment file is typically a batch of payment instructions, although you can create a file with just one payment in it. In order to create a file, we will first be setting up a payment group. The payment group is a container for payments of a similar type. To set up a payment group, starting from the home page, use the blue banner at the top of your screen to select Payments, Transfers, and Deposits. Then choose the More link under the ACH Direct Payments and Deposits heading. On the left-hand side menu, near the top, is the Payment Groups option. This page will show any existing groups that you have, or it may be blank if you're new to the platform. On this page, choose the blue Create Group button. A payment group is like a container or a virtual file folder which stores and organizes all of your payees or payors of a similar type. This group can reflect a general purpose, such as payroll, or vendors for direct deposits, or it could be rent or membership fees for incoming pre-authorized payments. You may also choose to create a group for a single payee or payor. When you create a group, you may need to choose your client number from a drop-down menu. My profile has one outgoing PDS client number and one PAP, which is incoming. Your options may be different based on what has been enrolled for your organization. Please also keep in mind that the steps to use the Record Manager are the same for incoming and outgoing payments. This client number will be the only difference in the process. So while I'm choosing to set up a PDS, Direct Deposits group, the steps will be the same if you're setting up a pre-authorized payment or PAP group for collecting payments. Next, give the group a name that reflects the purpose of your payments. This name will only be visible to your organization. The description box is optional, and the payment group type should remain regular. When you click Continue, you will be asked to make a few more selections. These selections are used by RBC and the recipient's bank to classify the purpose of the payments that you will be sending. When reviewing the information on this page, ensure that it consistently reflects the purpose of your payments. The most important fields on this page are the transaction code and the default company entry description. The transaction code helps classify the purpose of the payment. Some common codes are 200, payroll deposit, 460, accounts payable, and 400, which is rent/leases. The default company entry description must be typed in, and there is a maximum of 9 characters. This field may be displayed into your customer's account. Once you've made your selections, select the blue Continue button at the bottom. Review the details and select Save. Now that we've created a payment group, we have a space into which we can save the account details in the form of a payment record. The Payment Records heading is just underneath Payment Groups on the left-hand side menu. Under this heading, there are several options. Create is used to create a record of the account details. Inquire/modify is used to modify or delete an existing record. Express Entry can be used to set up multiple records at one time. And Global Changes is used to manage the dollar amounts that are attached to the records. On the Create page, you will be presented with a drop-down menu where you'll choose the group. Next, ensure the payment type matches your client number. Direct payments should be selected if you're using the PAP client number. Direct deposits should be selected if you're doing outgoing payments and using a PDB or PDS client number. The last selection here is destination country. While it is possible to send payments across the border into the US, your profile will need special permissions to do so. To move forward, select Continue. And now we can fill in the record of account details. Keep in mind that this screen will look the same whether the payment is incoming or outgoing. The only difference is the client number listed at the top. On this page, all fields marked with a red asterisk are required, and the first fields are customer name and customer number. The customer number can be any numbers or letters that help you identify this record. The customer name should be their full legal name. The payment short name will contain your organization name as it may appear in the customer's account. You'll notice that the amount field is marked with a red asterisk. If you are always or almost always paying or collecting the same dollar amount, you can enter that amount here. However, if your amounts are changing often or every time you're making a payment, you may also enter a zero. This field cannot be left blank, although it can be easily modified later using Global Changes. Then we come to the account details. Please take special care when entering account numbers. Errors in these fields could result in a payment being delayed, returned, or sent to an incorrect account. Enter the bank or financial institution number. This is typically 4 digits. You'll notice there's an optional gray verify button. Selecting this will confirm the name of the bank associated with the number that you have entered. Next is the branch or transit number. This is typically 5 digits. And finally, the account number will be 7 to 12 digits long. This last selection of details are optional. The payment number is already filled in as 00, and this only needs to be changed if you are purposefully creating duplicate records. The transaction code was selected when you set up the group and can be customized for this specific record if needed. The electronic message is optional, and not all banks will be able to display this message in an online statement. When you click Continue, RBC Express will review the record details. If all information is accurate, click Confirm to complete the record. If you have a large number of records that you need to add into a group at one time, you may also want to use Express Entry. This option allows you to add multiple payment records at one time. On this page, choose the group, select your payment type, and choose Continue. This page allows you to add up to 10 records at a time. All fields are mandatory. The next menu option is called Inquire/Modify. This is used to modify or delete existing payment records. Begin by selecting the group from the drop-down menu and enter at least one search criteria. Or use the amount range option at the bottom by entering 0 in the from field and 10,000 in the to field, or any amount larger than what you may have entered into the record. On the results page, you can check the boxes on the left to select the record that you need to remove or update, and use the blue buttons at the bottom to complete that action. The final menu option under the Payment Records heading is Global Changes. Similar to the Inquire and Modify section, Global Changes is used for updating your existing records. However, this option is used for updating the dollar amount only. Begin by selecting your payment group from the drop-down menu, and select one of the three options. Update all amounts to one common amount, update all by a percentage, or the most commonly used option is update individual amounts. This third option will bring up a list of the records in a group. On the right, you can enter an amount for each individual record. In the next video of this series, we will demonstrate how to use these groups and records to send a payment file. If you need to send a payment file using the group, but do not want to include all records in the group, you can exclude them from the file by setting the dollar amount to 0 in the Global Changes page. Records with a $0 amount will not be included in the file. This concludes part 1 of the ACH Record Manager series. Watch part 2 to learn how to use these groups and records to send a payment file.
If you have any questions about the features shown in this video, you can always contact the Client Support Center. Our phone number is at the bottom of your screen at all times.